Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel in depth, chapter 27, macro recording. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. Chapter 27 is all about VBA macros, and one bad decision that Microsoft made in the macro recorder. My classic example here is someone sent me this data set. This data set was supposed to be used for a mail merge, and the person who set it up didn't understand how it's supposed to be. Name in column A, address in column B, city, state, zip in column C. And I get this data, I'd offer to help with the mail merge, and now I realize, oh, fix all of these names. So that I said, simple enough, we'll just record a macro. The macro will be called fix one, and a shortcut key of Ctrl A stored in this workbook. Great. Macro's recording now, so I'm going to go down, cut the first name, go up, paste. Cut the city, state, and zip, paste in column C, delete those blank rows, and make sure that I'm on the next name. All right, so simple enough. But here's the problem with the default state of the macro recorder. The default state of the macro recorder is so literal, it does exactly what I do. So when I would press Control A again, it would go to cell A2, cut cell A2, watch this, paste to B1, oh, that's bad. Go down to A3, cut, go up to C1, paste, and then delete rows 2, 3, and 4. That's what the macro is going to do. So here, let me do it. I'll press Control A. Ruin that record. Ruin that record. Ruin that record. If I just hold down Control A, I can now destroy data faster than ever before. Not necessarily a good thing. All right, now here's the thing. That's the default state of the macro recorder. The funny thing is, there's a setting that lets us fix that. Why Microsoft doesn't turn this setting on by default, I have no idea. Use relative reference. Turn that on. It's both there on the View tab and back here on the Developer tab. You see it has a nice glow behind it. Now I'm going to record that macro again. So I'll call it fix one, try two. Now let's do Control S. Click OK. All right. Now that relative is on, it doesn't say go to cell A2. It says, oh, from wherever you started, go down one cell. Cut, go up, over, paste. Left, down two, cut, up two, over two, paste. Delete the next three rows. And then go up a cell, down a cell to make sure that we're on the next name. Stop recording. Control S. It works. Control S. Works. I can just hold down Control S and it's going to fix all of my records. Okay, so I think most people have a lot of problem with the Excel macro recorder because they don't understand relative reference. Microsoft would have been far better served to turn relative reference on by default. Okay, now that I've turned it on, it will stay on for the rest of the day or until I close Excel. But tomorrow, I open Excel again, back to turned off. They would make that one change, have relative turned on all the time. Most people would have much better experience. Okay, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.